was the last time you pranked someone?
Just a minute ago. No, probably. Oh, so I was 4th of July, my first 4th of July in America.
Yes.
Yeah, pretty fun.
America.
America. Yeah. America. Yeah. So, no, I was in Rhode Island at Taylor Swift's house.
At Natch, weren't we all?
Yeah.
Invite.
Were you guys not there?
It did feel like most of the world was there. And I was looking at it going, what's a guy got to do to get an invite out to Rhode Island? What's I got to do? Why did I not make the cut?
I don't know, James. You've got to ask yourself that.
Do you make the cut?
Yep.
Yeah?
I looked at that picture of them all on the balcony, on the chairs. I could have thought, I could have been next to Ryan Reynolds. Near my wife, or I could have been sat on Ryan Reynolds' lap.
And I would have loved to see that.
Why not? So what happened? What did you prank out there?
So, Kesha, she was sleeping on the top floor with the Haim sisters, and they were all in this kind of creepy area of the house. And they've been watching, like, murder mysteries all day. So me, Ruby Rose, and Uzo decided to become a ghost crew and started making this, like, massive plot to scare the crap out of them, basically. We got torches, speakers, we did sound effects. We were going to do, like, rocking chairs with bits of thread, like, outside. I mean, we went full in. We waited till they went to sleep at about 4 a.m. Told Taylor and Tom because the security is massive, so we don't want to get shot in America.
You don't want to mess with those guys. Twiddleston on your ass.
No, you don't want
Twiddleston. He's training to be Bond. You don't even need security. Right. Twiddleston will take you down.
So obviously I didn't want that. So we went, told them, and we kind of set it up, and it took a bit of a turn for the worse. They basically nearly called the police, which is funny because we're like, I love that you would call the police if you think there's a ghost outside of us. Yeah. Like, that's why there should be real Ghostbusters, just in case. So we actually had to tell them. But it went on for about 2 hours, and they never forgave us. We still aren't talking now.
No!
No, I'm joking.
Oh, good. I was going to say, don't be telling me the squad's broken up over a prank. Jeez.
But I think, because Taylor and Tom weren't there for the whole time, but they got woken up, and they came upstairs, and Uzo was in the corner with a light in her hand holding a speaker. I was throwing myself on the floor, punching things, and they were like, screaming, and they were like, okay, we're just going to walk back downstairs. I'll leave this scene.
Oh my, but Tom's the night manager. He could have dealt with it. That's amazing.
He was just peeing himself on the corner.